Let us pray. Father Lord, we thank you God, for this beautiful morning. We thank you for the freedom to worship you, Lord, not only with our singing and dancing, but with the substance, God, that you have given to us. And we thank you, God, for providing to each one of us. And that's the reason, Lord, why we are able to give to you. So, God, even as we will listen to your word this morning, God, we ask for your spiritual understanding that whatever word that we will hear today, Father God, it will strengthen us. It will give us a clear understanding on your grace. And Lord, we welcome the Spirit of grace, who is the Holy Spirit, to be our teacher this morning as we open our hearts to him. And Lord, we are so grateful to give to you all the glory and honor and thanksgiving. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, so usan tanan ulay nagluya ninyo. Ako nagluya ko nung hindi rong semana. Okay. I was battling the fever from Monday until yesterday. But bisag na ako'y hilanat, I have to be at the conferences. Ako'y mga bisitan taga Manila. So ako nung lamang giigwanta, dadala akong hilanat, gikag Lunes, hantod Huwebes. Nakahigda-higda ko, Bernis na. But praise the Lord, God is my strength.
Amen.
Paghuman sa paghuman po niya seminar, nagdubong na po kong pastor sa bahas. Paling ka po yan. So praise God. I still have to undergo laboratory tomorrow and x-ray. I hope everything will be okay. So this morning we will be talking about the beauty of God's grace. Okay. Basig mo tana mo hang sige balik-balik pang ng gracias, you know. Okay. Dili na to matugkad ang kalalom o kalapad sa himaya sa Diyos. Okay. And that's why we need to keep on studying and learning about the grace of God. So the title of this message is The Beauty of God's Grace. Okay, lingi ko kay. Kasi putol ba? Ganyan, putol tanan ng slide sa koan. I don't know, no. Wala man po nupulol ako ah. Okay, anyway, basic sa slides nga ilang gigamit. Ah, sa baba, slides nga ilang gigamit ba? Okay, why do we hide in life, especially from God? Kaya natay kinaiya nga when we fail God or we commit something bad, we feel guilty, we hide from Him. Okay? We stop going to church, we stop attending Bible studies, okay? We stop fellowshipping, we stop praying. Okay? Kasalay mo na, wala.
Amen.
Ha? Ay, gulaman itong wala kasulay. Matutpas sa Sprite, magpakatotoo ka. Okay. Muna'y kinabwi sa tao, mag-guilty ganita, mupalayo ta. Okay. So, one major reason na nung we hide from God because we have done something wrong. Okay. And one of the reason that we hide from God because we have also a wrong view of God. We see God to be an angry God. Okay. So, gamayin pa kong bata, kaskwila po ko sa San Pedro Academy, I view God as someone who is an old man with a white hair and holding a stick on his right hand, ready to hit anyone who will commit mistake. Okay. And perhaps that could be one of the reasons why we hide from God. Now, the first one to hide from God was Adam and Eve. Ningon ang Genesis chapter 3 verse 9 and 10. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was so naked, so I hid." So that was the first time that Adam hid from God. Because inyo nga pagkasala niya, that was the first time that he discovered that he was naked. Because before he was, before he committed sin, he was clothed with the glory of God. And Exodus 22:27 says, "And it will be that when he cries to me, I will hear, for I am gracious." Now, this is from the New Testament. Preachers in the old times presented God in the Old Testament as someone who is angry. But if you search the scripture, he is not an angry God. He is a loving God. He is a gracious God. This verse is one proof that he is gracious. He said, "I am gracious. If they will cry to me." Ang problema sa tao, when we commit sin, palayo tayo sa Ginoo. If only we will just come to him and say, "Lord, I fail you." So wala niyong problema. God is gracious. God is merciful. Okay? Another verse in the Old Testament, Nehemiah. "But you are God, ready to pardon, gracious and merciful, slow to anger, abundant in kindness." So that is who God is. We should not hide from him every time we fail. We should go straight to him. Okay? Because he is gracious, merciful, and slow to anger. So God does not want us to continue hiding from him because of our sins. Take note on that, ha? Dili ganahan ng Ginoo nga mo palayo ta niya kung kita nakasala. Ganahan siya nga mo adto ta niya, mo duol ta niya. Okay. Nga naman nga dili siya ganahan that we will hide from him because of our sins. What is the reason? What's the reason?
Because he loves us. He loves us. He loves us.
Huh? Every time you sin, he wants you to come to him. Why? Because of his love. Okay, see it? So, kinala na yung siko balik-balik o preach of grace. This is the reason why God wants you to come to him every time you feel him. Your sins qualifies you for his grace. Okay? Your sin qualifies you for his
grace. Amen.
So makasala ka, don't be guilty. Remind yourself, I am qualified to accept the grace of God. But it doesn't give you the license to sin. To commit sin.
That's the solution.
Because a lot of Christians misinterpreted the verse in Romans chapter 5 verse 20 that says, when sin abound, grace abounded more. Okay? So when on that verse, they interpreted it in this way nga, okay rin ang magpakasala. Kahit kung makasala, ta, bundan siya mabot ang gracias. Hinoo. No. Ang ipasabot ana nga versikulo is this. Kung nakasala mangani ka, ang gracias Ginoo mas dako pa sa nasala nga imong nahimo. So dili gyapon ka mahilayo sa Ginoo. Okay? Grace is not something nga you just close your eyes on sin. No. Grace recognizes the ugliness of sin sa tao. So, your sin will qualify you for
His grace.
His grace.
Amen.
Amen. We may be hiding and running from Him, but He is seeking us out. He is chasing us with His grace. Nakasala si Adan. Kinsa may nibulong.
God, where are you?
Ginoo. Sa kasala ta, kinsa may nibulong tayo pagkamatay. Si Jesus. When we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Okay? So, grace does not ignore sin. Grace recognizes the full ugliness of sin, yet offers undeserved pardon and blessing. Sa mga tao nga legalistic listen ni nila madawat. Okay. Because right now, there's, until now, dugan ni kayo nga debate between Arminian and Calvinism. Okay. The Arminian are fighting that ang kalawasan is both partly from God and partly from men. Nako ni party ang tao sa kalawasan. Kay dili lang kuno totally iya sa Ginoo. Sa Calvinism po, it is purely by the grace of God. Eh, which is more biblical. So, we have to remember that God has come to find us, no? Which is Christ, the grace of God. Okay? Grace has come to find us. Grace seek us where we are. Okay? Sa dihang nakasala, naglunang kas imong mga sala, diha ka makit-an sa grasya. Okay? One typical example ini from the Old Testament is Mephibosheth, and the, in the New Testament with Zacchaeus. Okay. Do you remember my sermon on Zacchaeus? The Gospel according to Zacchaeus. Limot na mo? Ang taas notebook ng gaspati. Okay, we will start with Zacchaeus. Who was Zacchaeus? He was the chief tax collector. He was corrupt. Ni dato kay siya tungod sa corruption. And he was a traitor to his people because he was working with the Roman government in collecting taxes from the Israelites. So, to the eyes of the Israelites, Zacchaeus was a traitor. He was even corrupt. I mean, people do not respect Zacchaeus because of his life nga iyang gi occupy or position nga iyang occupy itong panahon na. And are you familiar with the story of Zacchaeus? Huh? Yeah. Wala pa mong kadungog story of Zacchaeus?
Small boy.
Oh, kadungog mo. Zacchaeus, taas or putot?
Putot.
Oh, gusto kayo may singgit yung putot. Putot si Zacchaeus, niya sa iyang pagkaputot, nagkaguluyang itong siyudad kay maabot si Jesus. So, ang mga tao naglinya sa roadside kay Jesus is passing by. Ngayon, putot man si Zacchaeus, Kasi saon niyang tiking, iyang makita, abagaram niya po sa mga tao. So, ikat-kat siya sa kahoy nga, sycamore tree. Okay, nagkulabting siya dito sa sanga sycamore tree nga mura o, unggoy. So, and then, Jesus passed by. Ayun, nakita siya ni
Jesus.
Ayun, yun si Jesus kan Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus, come down. Because I will dine with you in your house today. So, dalit-daling nanaog si Zacchaeus. Pero ang mga Pariseo nga naglantaw, nagbagot-bot. Nga nung muadto siya sa panimalay sa Osaka, makasasala. Eh. So, Jesus was not concerned about the occupation and reputation of Zacchaeus. But he was deeply concerned for his salvation because he loved him. He loved him. To Jesus, his occupation and his reputation being a corrupt person doesn't matter to him. What is more important is for Zacchaeus to receive his salvation. Mutanan ko ninyo. Ni-initiate ba si Zacchaeus o ingon, Lord? Alin ako, Lord, dawatog di ka. Wala. And then, I remember my preaching about Zacchaeus. Ningon niya, ningon to sana ko kapunto nga. When Jesus considered Zacchaeus to be his friend, he took something from him. What did Jesus took something from Zacchaeus? He took something from him, the shame, the guilt, and the humiliation. When Jesus came into the house of Zacchaeus, Jesus gave him something. He gave him a sense of dignity. When he dined with Zacchaeus, na-feel ni Zacchaeus that he was clean and accepted. And because of this, it leads Zacchaeus into repentance. Wala ningon si Zacchaeus, Lord, pasila ko sa humang sala, kaya ko na kong makasasala. Wala. He just put it into action. Ingin siya, Lord, I will give half of my possessions to the poor. And to anyone nga akong gi deceive sa ilang tax, I will pay them back 4 times. Okay. And then, on sa may sulti sa Biblia, pag-ingon ni Jesus nga salvation, at pag-ingon ni Zacchaeus nga, Lord, half of my possession I will give it to the poor. And I will pay back 4 times every person nga akong na-deceive. Okay. Unsa sulti Jesus? Position din Jesus. Aminan mo, ha? Okay? Akong balihon inyong theology. Okay. Pag-ingon ni Zacchaeus, I will give half of my position to the poor, and I will pay back 4 times every person nga akong na-deceive. Jesus said, salvation
has
come
into the house,
into
this house,
this household. It never says salvation has come
to you,
to Zacchaeus. Okay? Now, from the contemporary English Bible, it says, Jesus said to him, to Zacchaeus, today salvation has come to this household because he too is a son of Abraham. Iyan itawag si Zacchaeus nga, anak ni Abraham. From the contemporary English version, you listen carefully, yeah? Jesus said to Zacchaeus, today you and your family have been saved. It never say that only Zacchaeus is saved. Ako subasa. Luke 19, pwede niyo sulat ni. Luke 19, verse 9, contemporary English version. Jesus said to Zacchaeus, today, you and your family have been saved. Pilay na luwas?
Household.
It's the household. It's only by the grace of God. Okay. It's not my word. Now let me read it from the God's Word translation. Luke 19, verse 9, God's Word translation. Then Jesus said to Zacchaeus, you and your family have been saved today. You have shown that you too are one of Abraham's descendants. Tolo na kaklaseng translation. Amen? Do you have any support on this? Acts 16, verse 31, NIV. Katuning Jill Warden.
Warden.
Nga itong kapiso ni Paul o ni Silas. Okay? Iinan siya ni Paul o Silas, believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved.
You and your household.
You and your household. Eh, swerte mo karon o naluwas mo. Inyong pamilya, luwas. I remember the description in the Corinthians, nganingon si Pablo, if the husband is a Christian, and the wife is not a Christian, and the husband decided to live with his unbelieving wife, yun siya man ang Biblia.
The unbelieving wife will be,
and the children will be made holy. And if the wife is the believing and the husband is the unbelieving, but the wife decided to live with her unbelieving husband, her unbelieving husband, and their children will be made holy. The same principle. Okay? I remember one verse during the first Passover. When was the first Passover took place? In Egypt. Before the 10th plague, God told them to prepare for the Passover, that they have to, each family has to slay a lamb and put a blood on the doorpost, okay? And death will just pass over. And there's one verse in that story that says, only one lamb
for family.
Lamb for family. Each family. Di na kailangan magtanang sa pamugihaw o kwa. Just one lang. That's why when Zacchaeus was saved, ningon Jesus, you and your family. Di ni mabuak na imong theology on panabitan mo, mampu mulawas, kawa mampu mahinulsol. You know what? We cannot understand the grace of God. We cannot fathom the grace of God. I could not understand why would Jesus die for me when I was still a sinner. I could not understand why nga apilon sa kinungluwas ang pamilya ni Zacchaeus. But since it is God who said it, I believe it. Even if my mind doesn't agree with it. Amen. His word is truth. And if nobody believe in this truth, it is still truth. Okay. If a lie, if there's a lie and everybody believe in that lie, that's still a lie. But the truth is different. Even if nobody believe it, it is still the truth.
It will set you free.
Huh?
The truth will set you free.
Yeah, the truth will set you
free.
Free. So baliktas. Ikuan. Zacchaeus. Okay. So grace, God's grace initiate the relationship. He does not wait around for us to come to Him. God seek us out and find us where we are. Hindi talaga nang Ginoo paagi nga madakpan yung ka. So, kana magong grace, gapurso na niya mo. Wala ko tayo may mo. Ang atong kahintang mauni, tulog ka buo. We were falling in sin. Okay? Kaya nalaglag man sa sala, we were far from God. Okay? Ano mang nalitas Ginoo kay? Nahadlok man ta sa Diyos. Okay? But, grace will
bring
us to the King's presence. Okay? Let's go to the life of Mephibosheth. Who is Mephibosheth? Anak ni? Tarpolano? Anak ni Boset? Anak ko na nasa Biblia. Anak ka na Biblia, right? Kaya ni Spati ko. Si Mephibosheth, anak siya ni Jonathan. Apo siya ni King Saul. Si Mephibosheth na paralyzed. Kaya nabuhian siya si iyang nurse. So na-crippled siya. Di siya kalakaw. And Jonathan and David,
friends.
Not they are not only friends, but they are covenant brother. They cut covenant with each other. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Katong walo ka 1.5 liters nga coke sa balay. Napay limang nabilin. Okay. Asa na ta? Pasta coke lagi mahanaw atong memory. Okay, David and Jonathan cut covenant, okay? And because they are in covenant relationship. Sa diyang namatay na si King Saul, namatay niya po si Jonathan. David became king. He became king, eh? All over Israel. Okay? Okay, there was a time na he was only king between, only king on the two tribes. The tribe of Benjamin and the tribe of Judah. Okay? He was not king sa tanan. But pagkamatay na ni King Saul, nahari na siya sa tibuok Israel. And then, while on his throne, he remembered Jonathan. siya basit pag nabilin nga kaliwat ni Jonathan. So nagpasugo siya. Basit nabilin pang kaliwat ni Jonathan. So, ningon ang Biblia, David wanted to show kindness to anyone nga kaliwat ni Jonathan. The word kindness in that verse is chesed. Chesed is so closely related to grace. So he wanted to show grace sa kanang kaliwat ni Jonathan. Did somebody told him, naiusang survival. Tuas lasang nagtago-tago kay hadlok siya nga patyo nimo. Kay hadlok ang kanang kaliwat ni Jonathan ang hadlok ni David. Kay patyon siya ng David kay si Jonathan at si King Saul iya magong patyon si David. Kaya was ibabalos ba si David? Then somebody told David, nay anak si Jonathan nga si Mephibosheth. Tuas sa Lodibar. Under the care of Ziba. So, ipasugo, ipasuguan siya sa hari. Bring Mephibosheth to the palace. Lodibar, at the end, diha nagpuyo si Koan, si Mephibosheth, it means no pasture, no hope. So, nagpuyo siya sa lugar nga, no pasture, no hope. Kay kanang tao nga layo sa Ginoo, wa yun na yung provision, wala po'y
pag-asa, paglaom.
So Mephibosheth was brought to the king's palace against his will. Kay hadlok siya nga, patyon siya ni King David. So pag-abot dito sa palace, nakuratan si Koan. Nakuratan si Mephibosheth, because what he received from King David were all just good thing, okay? So, idala siya sa palace, then he received three blessings of grace. Grace brings acceptance in the beloved. So, ningundere, do not fear, for I will surely show kindness to you for the sake of your father, Jonathan, Gina, and David, I have God, look, I will show you kindness, I will show you grace for the sake of your father, Jonathan. You know what? Grace will make you part of God's beloved. Mga hinigugma, mga pinalangga sa Diyos. That's why, ningon ang Ephesians chapter 1, accepted in the beloved. You and me are accepted in the beloved na daw. Gidawa ta diha sa mga pamilya, mga pinalangga sa Diyos. Okay. Di ba ito na ikanta sa Binisaya nga?
Pinalangga sa Ginoo.
Pinalangga sa Ginoo. Pagka, pagkalami.
Favorite ni Sister Amay.
O, pagka maayo.
Pinalangga
man
sa atong Ginoo.
Sa atong Ginoo.
Okay.
That's the first blessing that you will receive from grace. It will bring you into the family of God. You will be part of the beloved of God. Okay. And then number two, grace brings blessing beyond measure. Sinigos David, I will restore to you all the land that belonged to your grandfather Saul, and you will always eat at my table. Look at that blessing. Wow. I will restore to you all the land of your grandfather Saul. Okay. Ragasinda. Labaw pa sa sinda ng yutang Saul. And in spite of that, napay dugang, you will always eat at my table. He will always eat at the king's table. Always. So, nadihat ng mga ham. Nadihat ng mga Kobe beef. Kanang mga makapalaway ni mo, nadihat. Amen. So King David assigned her band no, to farm Mephibosheth's land to ensure regular provision. Si David pa ni provide of mga laborers to farm the land of
David.
Mephibosheth. Di na siya maghago. That's grace. Okay. Wala na kalami ang hinsuon. Sa grasya sa Diyos. Number three, grace brings communion with the king. Ningon dere. So Mephibosheth ate at David's table like one of the king's son. He is not only a visitor. He is just like son of David. Amen. Hallelujah.
So good.
The beauty of grace. So Mephibosheth had a young son named Micah, and all the members of Ziba's household were servants of Mephibosheth. And Mephibosheth lived in Jerusalem because he always ate at the king's table. He was lame in both feet. Ang nakalabi ay ding gracia, Mignon, ikaw ang utang mo dawa. In grace, your only duty is to receive, never to earn. Amen. God has called us into fellowship with Him and with His Son. And He has made us members of His family where we share together the bounty of His table. His grace has brought us into sweet daily communion with the King of Kings and His children. Okay. Amen. So, katahom sa grasya. That's the beauty of grace. Okay. Grace will set you free. Okay. Grace sets us free from the bondage and power of sin. Grace sets us free from guilt, condemnation, and shame. Grace sets us free from rejection, bitterness, anger, insecurity, and unforgiveness. Grace sets us free to live a life in the Spirit. Grace sets us free so we can enjoy God's love. Okay? No failure or weakness or sin can hold us captive because God in His grace is prepared to set us free. Amen. Ay, wala man eh. Sorry. Amen. So what does grace look like?
Look like Pastor George.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Okay. What does grace look like? Okay. Thank you. What is your grace? Grace build up. It doesn't tear down. Grace gives what is undeserved, focusing on mercy, not justice. Grace is costly. Grace gives without expecting anything in return. Grace think of others, not self. Okay, wala pa na. Okay. Grace focuses on the important, not on the trivial. Grace help people become more like Christ. Grace doesn't condemn or give up on people. Okay? God will never give up on us. Grace does not focus on what is, but what could be. Grace is not fixated on the past, but looks towards the future. To God, what is more important is your future, not your past. Okay. Under the grace of God, He will never consult your past to determine your future. Amen?
Amen. Thank you.
Grace is also transformative. Apostle Paul, life epitomizes God's grace at work. He was extremely zealous of his religion, so arrogant and self-righteous, enormously ambitious, and totally committed to his cause. But grace transformed him. Apostle Paul was known to be the Hebrew of all Hebrews. That's the title of Apostle Paul. Before he was converted by grace, he was the Hebrew of all Hebrews. Grabe kayo. He was the top student of Gamaliel. Gamaliel was the, I would say, the top and the highly respected theologian during the time of Paul. And he was the top student of Gamaliel. Dagoan pa ni, labaw pa ni summa cum laude. Summa cum laude ako na rin eh. Kasi yung pagka-bright kayo. And yet, in spite of that, he was totally transformed. Now show me a verse in the Bible that Paul repented before he received grace. Where was Paul receive his conversion?
Damascus.
On the road to Damascus. What was he doing on the road to Damascus?
Persecuting the church.
Antado? Now, he was on the way to Damascus with only one mission, to kill more Christians. Look at that. Here comes Paul, gaaso ng ilong sa kalagot sa mga born again. He wants to go to Damascus and kill every born again Christian. And on the top, at the peak of his anger, Jesus appeared to him.
Great light strike him.
Kita siya, hayag kayo. Sa kahayag na buta siya. Paul, why do you persecute me?
Who are you, Lord?
Who are you, Lord? Who are you, Lord? I am?
Jesus.
Wag niyo sa Paul, Lord, pasayaw ako. You cannot read it in the Bible. There's none. But the issue is this. He was at the peak of his anger to kill more Christian that he encountered grace. Because of that encounter, he got born again. And it took him 3 more years before siya nabalik sa ministry. After that encounter, nag-sabbatical leave siya 3 katuig. For what purpose? To unlearn everything. And for him to receive revelations of grace upon grace upon grace upon grace. And after 3 years, he went into the ministry and he became the apostle of grace.
Amen.
Amen. Now, are we becoming a person of grace? If you're
yes, Lord, thank you.
So we need to consider something. Number one, consider the source of grace. If you are a Christian, don't assume your conversion automatically made you a person of grace. Okay? It doesn't guarantee na born again na karon, person of grace na ka. No. Why? Because there are many graceless Christians. Dagan Christian na walay grasya. Puno rin yung kalagot, puno rin yung kaligot-got, dili mo pasaylo.
Disgrasya na.
What they have is disgracia, dili gracia. The key is allowing the Holy Spirit to work in us to produce grace that we can extend to others. Okay? We need to become grace giver or grace ambassadors. Consider your own need for grace. This is one thing that every one of us should realize, that every day we need the grace of God. Okay? One of the biggest mistakes a Christian can make is to lose sight on the reality that we are all sinners and in need of God's saving grace. Not only that you are in need of God's saving grace, but every day we need His grace. We need God's grace every day. Okay. Pag mata na to, we should be praying, Lord, fill me with your grace today so I may be able to handle my problems. And by your grace, God, I may be able to find solutions to my problems. Lord, give me your grace that I may be able to carry the burden of life today. Lord, give me grace that I need, Lord, to run my business well. Okay. Whatever your position in life, you need grace. Every day, you need grace. But how many of us are asking for grace every day? Don't forget that the grace of God is His enablement and His power. Meaning, when you ask for His grace, you are asking, Lord, enable me today to carry my burden. Enable me today to solve my problem. That's why we need grace every day, because God's grace is enablement. Okay? Number three, consider other people's need for grace. It's not only you who need grace. Other people need grace also. Okay? So if you consider those around you, you need grace just like you, you will relate to them differently. Okay. Makasabot ka, kaya naman, kaya na sila grasya. Tingali ingon ana iyang kahintang, o tingali ingon ana iyang attitude karon, kaya na kaya na sila grasya sa Ginoo. Now you are there. You are supposed to be the grace giver. Okay. Extend grace to that person. How do you extend grace to that person? By showing kindness to him, by helping him, by praying for him. Okay? There's so many ways to give grace. Okay? If he need food, give him something to eat. Okay? Ask God to fill your heart with His grace. There are so many grace. Ningon si Peter siyang isayang epistle. The manifold of grace, meaning, unsa man pasabot og manifold? Different forms, different kinds of grace. How many of you heard the word actual grace? Wala pa. Sanctifying grace, sustaining grace, prevenient grace. Wala pa. Ato yan ang iwalay para So, it is incomprehensible how deeply people hurt, okay? Ang tao nga, nasakitan, makapasakit na pinas uban. Okay? And when you are deeply hurt because you have an abusive father, or you have an unfaithful partner, or you have someone in your family that hit you physically, or you have a teacher that really hated you so much, okay? Or somebody raped you or whatever. You know what? In this type of part, humanly speaking, it's hard to forgive. Humanly speaking, it is hard to forgive. That's why we need grace.
Amen.
We need grace. Because without grace, we cannot totally forgive. We cannot really forgive without His grace. So we need the grace of God. Only God is loving and gracious enough to do that. I was listening today to the testimony of the daughter of Peter Tanchi. He was raped by 4 men. Patka, lalaki, and nag-rape niya. Terrible. And yet, he continued serving God. And she said, without the grace of God, I could never forgive them. Never. I know there are instances at Okinawa na we really need the grace of God to forgive someone. We need the grace of God to love them. So we need to open our lives to God for Him to fill it with His grace, love, and mercy so we can bless others. Now, number 5 is look for opportunity to share grace. Grace givers look for practical ways to show kindness to others. Opportunities to give grace abound. Okay. Let's read Romans 2 verse 14. Or do you feel contempt for the riches of His kindness, forbearance, and patience, not realizing that God's kindness is intended to lead you to repentance? You want people to truly experience true repentance? Show them kindness. The old school of bringing people into repentance is this. Okay? Repent or you will go to hell. That's the way we do in the old school. If you will not repent, you will go to hell. You will never go to heaven. If you will not repent and you will die tonight, you will go to hell. Scare tactics. So what happened? They repent. But after 2 days, 3 days, they're back again on their old life. There's no true repentance. Now, as far as the Bible is concerned, that true repentance can only be experienced by the sinners by showing kindness to them. Okay? Now, this is NIV. We will read New King James. Do you despise the riches of His goodness, forbearance, and long-suffering, not knowing that the goodness of God leads you to repentance? Now, the NIV speaks of kindness. The King James Version speaks of goodness. Maragaya po na. Show goodness to someone. Pakitaig kayo ng uban. Grace doesn't make you self-centered, but grace make you other-centered. Show them kindness. Kana bitong daga, kana kung kasurubran ng uban niyo sa balay, pangatag. Sa'yo ma, naglanta ko sa'yo nga, ang daga naman yung pagkaon na ito, yung panghatan na ito, ni. Ang ato buong kuwan, ay puso na na, buta na na slip, kainito na na, anto lang mga panos. May panghatan pa ito, dahan pang na-bless. Di ba? Amen. Katugatan. Okay, but the New Century Version, He has been very kind and patient, waiting for you to change. But you think nothing of His kindness. Perhaps you do not understand that God is kind to you, so you will change your heart and live. lahi pa ning New Century Version. Ang Ginoo napakita kayo ni mo harong kamag usab harong kamag binag-o. Amen? So be a grace giver. Do not keep grace just within yourself. Extend it to someone. There are so many people who need grace. Point the way for them to follow and find grace. Find Jesus. Amen? Don't let grace remain merely a doctrine. Let grace become a lifestyle. Amen? I told you before that there was a pastor in Mindanao, a Baptist pastor. Naimusimba sa iyang simbahan inside the church, budagpot pag sigrilyo. Simbahan na Pentecostal, di ba, pagwao na. Pero ang pastor kay kasabot ang siyang grasya, hindi e lang pastor, brat, ako'y dagkot, bro. Siya'y dagkot sa kwan. Every time musulod itong, pag sunod Sunday, musulod itong taong aksyong kuot sa sirilyo, doon, pastor, ako'y dagkot, bro. Abot tungkol sa kaulaw, liundang tabako. Bakit ikayo? Kain pa tong pastor, ikaw, liyagun ko ka, nasunod simbahan. A grace giver. Are you a grace giver?
Amen.
You know what? If you are not a grace giver, you have not really received grace. Sorry to say that. Because a person who truly experiences the grace of God will be transformed into a grace giver. He will become the grace ambassadors. Amen. Father Lord, I thank you for your word this morning. God, I pray that by your grace you will teach your people to be grace givers, to be grace ambassadors. That through their life, Father God, they will be kind enough and good enough to people who need grace. That through their life, Father God, those people will see Jesus and receive Him and they will experience grace. Lord, I pray that you will inculcate it in the hearts of these people, Father God, and use them mightily for your kingdom. Salamat kino that as they step in faith to become grace givers, they will see harvest of souls, that more souls will come into the kingdom of God. And Lord, that will make you even more happy, God. Salamat kino. Help us, Lord, that the grace that we have, the grace that we learn is not just a doctrine. Help us, Lord, that it will be a lifestyle. You know, salamat. Ikaw magapanlangin padayon sa patag-usa. That you will provide for each one of us. You will preserve each one of us. And Lord, I thank you, God, that as long as you are the God of grace, we are in good hands. Salamat kino. May we continue to praise you and bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Next, we have a God who is the God of all grace. God, as we depart from this place, God, I thank you that you will fill our hearts with your grace. Your grace will sustain us this week. Your grace will provide for us. Your grace will bring healing to us. Your grace, Father God, will bring promotion to each one of us. Your grace will prosper the businesses of your people and bless the works of their hand. Thank you, Father God. Your grace will bring peace and harmony in the families of your people. Alaykum ka, Lord, sa katapusan, among kagitay, kipasalamatan. Namin the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you, now and forever, and all people of God says,
Amen.
Thank you and God bless you. Napay pataon.
Okay, have a seat. Okay, get on.